I'm Margaret Ross, CEO of the Cameron Institute. I grow and encourage people in business and in their lives. That's why we're introducing Cameron PI, the Positive Impact online newsletter. Subscribe today to receive email tips and articles about career, personal development, business, and parenting. Plus, as a limited time bonus, confirm your subscription and you'll also receive 52 ways to save money on practically everything. You don't want to miss out on this special offer. Go to cameron.org/PI for positive impact dash email. Subscribe today.
Our first Mason stop is with Mrs. Hinkle's class. There's a whole lot of learning and fun going on over there.
Hello, I'm Jennifer Hinkle, a Mason Elementary teaching team representative for second grade. The activity I'm going to highlight for you is through these glasses. It supports our school team's KC3 Positive Label program, social studies, and language arts skills. I created this strategy for my students to practice noticing the positive characteristics of important figures that we study. We use a write-on wipe-off graphic organizer that looks like a pair of yellow glasses. The students also each get their own copy of the organizer on paper. Before the class begins study of the assigned historical figures, I tell them we will be comparing the positive characteristics of the two figures and to be making note of any that they find. After our study is completed, I explain the task in detail and give each of them a copy of the graphic organizer to fill out. The students use the notes they have taken and refer back to the reading material as needed. When the students are finished, I ask for their input to fill out the large graphic organizer as a class. We discuss the positive characteristics of the figures, how it relates to what they did, and how they compare with each other.
What was your favorite thing about this lesson?
I really like how easy it is to incorporate the KC3 program into our curriculum. With this activity, not only do the students pay closer attention to details, they also often make a personal connection and retain more of the identifying information. Regardless of the subject area, a KC3 activity always excites my students and keeps them moving in a positive direction.
The students in Mrs. Donna Bulmer's classroom are affectionately known as the Bulmer Bears. Her students learn how to be kind and understanding while also learning reading, writing, and poetry. Mrs. Bulmer, what will we see your students learning today?
The activity I'm going to highlight for you is a lesson on adjectives. It supports our school team's KC3 Positive Label program and language arts skills. I created this strategy for my students to better enable them in using descriptive language and build on giving their peers positive labels. This, in turn, will aid in boosting their self-confidence as well as their self-image and self-worth. My goal is for each child to feel valued and respected for both their inner and outer self. I would also like for them to always look for and see the good in each other. For this lesson, you will need the KC3 books provided by the KC3 Positive Label program, a whiteboard or chart paper large enough to complete an adjective word splash, an easel and dry erase markers to list positive labels about our peers, an acrostic poem template, and pencils and crayons for the students to complete their poems. Prior to the lesson, I reread and reviewed our KC3 Positive Label program books with the students, encouraging them to relate to how Casey was feeling in various parts of the story. I encourage the students to relate to Casey by discussing how they might have felt or what they would have done in a similar situation. But most importantly, I wanted the students to see how positive labels build us up and how negative labels can deflate us. I asked the students to brainstorm positive labels about our friends as well as Casey. I listed these words on the whiteboard in the front of the room, using most of the board in a word splash format. I wanted to make this very colorful, using many different color markers so that this word splash would jump out at the students. When it was complete, I asked the students to look over the words and see what they all had in common. I was thrilled to hear them all state that they were adjectives. I asked students to then join me on the carpet in front of my rocking chair and easel, so that I could review how positive labels build us up and negative labels deflate us. I asked a student to come up and show me, using their body language, how a positive label can make us feel and how our body shows this with the way we stand, shoulders back and our head held high. We then used a negative label and showed how this deflates us by our shoulders falling forward and our head looking down. I then asked how we want to make others feel. I asked the students if they remembered what an acrostic poem was. We reviewed the rules of creating acrostic poems, and I had us complete one together using the words from our word splash on the board. I told them today they were going to use Casey's positive labels or adjectives to create an acrostic poem for a friend in our class. I handed out the acrostic poem worksheet to each child with the name of a fellow student already prepared on the acrostic poem template. I asked that they think carefully of that child and list words that would build their friend up. I also asked that they illustrate their poem with a picture of their special friend. As the students worked, we discussed how we could use our acrostic poem on a day when we might be feeling down. I encouraged the students to take out their poem, read it, and feel good about themselves after reading all the positive labels our peers have written about us.
Did you see any changes in student behavior?
I have noticed an increase in my students using positive labels in their conversations, as well as seeing them see the positive side of others when challenging situations occur. My class is now more focused on working together as a team because they continue to look for the good in each other and encourage rather than discourage one another.
You're watching KC3 TV, a public service of the Cameron Institute.